So what we have depicted here is a unit circle centered at point A, and the point B lies on the circle, and then we dropped a perpendicular from point B to point D. Point D lies on the positive x-axis, and they form this triangle ABD. And they tell us that angle BAD, angle bad, it has a measure of pi over 4 radians. What I want to do in this video is use our knowledge of trigonometry and use our knowledge of triangles in order to figure out several things. So the first thing we want to figure out is what's the measure of angle, what's the radian measure, what's the radian measure of angle ABD, of angle ABD. Actually, let's just do that first, and then I'll talk about the other things that we need to think about. So I assume you've paused the video and tried to do this on your own. So let's think about what ABD would be. We know two of the angles of this triangle, so if we know two of the angles of this triangle, you should be able to figure out the third. Now what might be a little bit unfamiliar, we're used to saying that the sum of the interior angles of a triangle add up to 180 degrees. But now we're thinking in terms of radians. So we could say that the sum of the angles of a triangle add up to, instead of saying 180 degrees is the same thing as pi radians. So this angle plus that angle plus that angle are going to add up to pi. So let's just say that this right over here, let's just say measure of angle ABD in radians plus pi over 4, plus this is a right angle. What would that be in radians? Well, a right angle in radians, a 90 degree angle in radians, is pi over 2 radians. So plus pi over 2. When you take the sum of them, the interior angles of this triangle, they're going to add up to pi radians, which is, of course, the same thing as 180 degrees. And now we can solve for the measure of angle ABD. Measure of angle ABD is equal to pi minus pi over 2 minus pi over 4. I just subtracted these two from both sides. So this is going to be equal to, let's see, we could put a common denominator of 4. Then this is 4 pi over 4. This is minus 2 pi over 4. And this, of course, is minus pi over 4. So 4 minus 2 minus 1 is going to get us to 1. So this is going to give us 2 pi over 4. So the measure of angle ABD is actually the same as the measure of angle BAD. It is pi over 4. So that angle right over there is pi over 4. Now what does that help us with? So if we know that this is pi over 4, and that is pi over 4 radians, and once again, we know this is a unit circle. So we know that the length of segment AB, which is a radius of the circle, or is the radius of the circle, is length 1. What else do we know about this triangle? Can we figure out the lengths of segment AD and the length of segment DB? Well, sure. Because we have two base angles that have the same measure, that means that the corresponding sides are also going to have the same measure. That means that this side is going to be congruent to that side. I can reorient it in a way that it might make it a little easier to realize. If we were to flip it over, if we were to make it look like this, so the triangle, we could make it look like, let me make it look a little bit more like this. Actually, I want to make it look like a right angle, though. So my triangle, let me make it look like, there you go. So if this is D, this is B, this is A, this is our right angle. Now this is pi over 4 radians, and this is also pi over 4 radians. When your two base angles are the same, you know you're dealing with an isosceles triangle. But because they're not all the same, you know it's not equilateral. If all of the angles were the same, this would be equilateral. But this is an isosceles non-equilateral triangle. So if your base angles are the same, then you also know that the corresponding sides are going to be the same. These two sides are the same. This is an isosceles triangle. And so how does that help us figure out the lengths of the sides? Well, if you say that this side has length x, then that means that this side has length x. If this side has length x, then this side has length x. And now we can use the Pythagorean theorem. We could say that this x squared plus this x squared is equal to the hypotenuse squared, is equal to 1 squared. Or we could write that 2x squared is equal to 1, or that x squared is equal to 1 over 2, or just taking the principal root of both sides, we get x is equal to 1 over the square root of 2. And a lot of folks don't like having a radical in the denominator. They don't like having a rational number in the denominator. So we could rationalize the denominator by multiplying by the square root of 2 over the square root of 2, which would be, let's see, the numerator will have the square root of 2, and in the denominator, we're just going to have square root of 2 times square root of 2 is just 2. So we've already been able to figure out several interesting things. We were able to figure out a measure of angle ABD in radians. We were able to figure out the lengths of segment AD and the length of segment BD. Now what I want to do is figure out what are the sine, cosine, and tangent of pi over 4 radians, given all of the work that we have done. So let's first think about what is the sine. Let me do this in a color, do it in orange. Given all the work we've done, what is the sine of pi over 4 radians? And I encourage you once again, pause the video, think about the unit circle definition of trig functions, and think about what this is. Well, the unit circle definition of trig functions, and this angle, this pi over 4 radians, is forming an angle with the positive x-axis, and where its terminal ray intersects the unit circle, the x and y coordinates of this point are what specify the cosine and sine. So the coordinates of this point are going to be the cosine of pi over 4 radians is the x coordinate, and the sine of pi over 4 radians is the y coordinate, sine of pi over 4. So what's the y coordinate going to be if we want the sine of pi over 4? Well, it's going to be this length right over here, which is the same thing as this length, which is the length of x, which is square root of 2 over 2. Now what is the cosine of pi over 4? And once again, I encourage you to pause the video to think about it. What's this x coordinate? What's the x coordinate? The x coordinate is this distance right over here, which is once again going to be x, which is square root of 2 over 2. Now, what is the tangent of pi over 4 going to be? Well, the tangent of pi over 4 is just sine of pi over 4 over cosine of pi over 4. Now, both of these are this exact same thing. They're both square root of 2 over 2. So you're going to have square root of 2 over 2 divided by square root of 2 over 2. Well, that's just going to give you 1. And that also makes sense, because remember, the tangent of this angle is the slope of this line. And we see the slope. For every x we move in the horizontal direction, we move x up. So our change in y over change in x is essentially x over x, which is equal to 1.